Good morning, students. Let us start part 1 from chapter 4, Lines and Angles. It is very important chapter from one of the branch of mathematics, geometry. Children, today we discuss about fundamental elements of geometry. Geometry is hidden around us all the time. It involves in our day-to-day life that we don't even notice it. Euclid, a great mathematician, who was the first person to collect all the work done on geometry. So, he is known as father of geometry. Now, let us learn fundamental elements of geometry. Children, you observe here, I put a dot on a paper. What can we call this? The dot on this surface gives us an idea of point. So, a point is an exact location. So, where we use the point? Now, for example, observe this map. If you notice in this India map, I locate exact positions of different places using points. So, from this, we can easily search any location. Like Vijayawada, Hyderabad, Visakhapatnam, Bhopal, Agra, and so on. And one more example. Children, as soon as you wake up in the morning, we will see the clock. Isn't it? Yes. If you observe the clock, the hands of a clock rotate from a fixed position. Here, this fixed position gives an idea of point. One more thing you have to remember that a point has no dimensions. No dimensions means it has no length, no breadth, no height. Now, how to name a point? Usually, we name a point by using a single capital letter like point A, point B, point P, point X, and so on. So, this is about point. Now, here you observe. Here, I joined two points using a straight path. So, what is the distance between the two points called? The distance between two points, including the endpoints, is called a line segment. So, a line segment is formed by joining any two points in a straight direction. So, how many endpoints do we have for line segment? Here one and here one. So, line segment has two endpoints. As we know the both ends, it has definite length. As line segment has definite length, it can be measured. So, how can we measure the line segment? Yes, by using scale. Now, how can we name the line segment here? Here, if you observe the line segment, here end points I named as point A and point B. So, it can be named as AB and a right tiny line segment over it. Or, it can also be written as BA and a tiny line segment over it. How can we read this? We can read this as line segment AB or here this is line segment BA. Now, here you observe the examples of line segment in our surroundings. Here is a blackboard. Around the edges of the blackboard, if you observe, we can find line segments. Here to here one line segment, here to here one, here to here third one, and here to here fourth one. So around the edges of the blackboard, which gives an idea of line segment. So here, similarly, we have window. Around the edges of the window, which gives an example of line segment. Similarly, if you observe this white paper, so edges of the paper. Like that, if you observe the scale here, so here, edges of the scale also, we can give example for line segment. So this is the way many examples of line segments in our surroundings we can observe. Now let us move to the another concept. Children, if you observe here, this line segment extended in both directions. If you extend like this, we get a line. So in this figure, arrow ends tells us there is no end in both directions. So a line is a straight that extends endlessly in both directions. Children, for example, when you are traveling on a road, if you observe the path, no end on both directions, which gives an idea of line. As the line represented here with arrowheads, it has no endpoints. As the line has no endpoints, it has no definite length. As the line has no definite length, it cannot be measured. Now, if you observe here, a line segment is a part of line. Now, how can we name this line? Now, here, again, same letters I used, but here, top of these letters I represented with line. So, it represents that AB is a line. Or we can write BA and a right tiny line over it. How to read this? This can be read as line AB, or here this can be read as line BA. And sometimes we can also use a single lowercase letter to represent a line. Here I represented with small l. Like that we can use small a, small b, small x, small z and so on. So this is about line. Let us move to the another concept. Here children, what do you notice in this geometrical figure at both ends? Here we have end point, other end we have arrow. So we name this figure as ray. The point at which ray begins is end point. The arrow on the other side represents that there is no end in this direction. It means that a ray that extends endlessly in one direction. How many endpoints does the ray have here? We have only one endpoint. So it has only one endpoint. Do we know the other end? No. So here it has no definite length. Because we know one end, we don't know the other end. As we don't know the other end, it cannot be measured. So a ray cannot be measured. So how can we name the ray? Children, when you are naming the ray, you should be very careful. You have to name the ray starting with the end point. If you observe the figure here, what is the end point here? A. So always you have to start with the end point, followed by letter B, and write a tiny ray over it. So this is the way we have to represent. This should not be named as BA ray, because B is not the endpoint. How to read this? This can be read as ray AB. Now here you observe one interesting example. So here the best example for ray, the rays which are extending from the sun. As we know that sun rays are coming from the sun. So here sun is the end point and the rays which are extending from the sun, here the rays are extending from the sun in different directions. And one more example, children, you see this. This is a torch. Now here, when you switch on a torch, the light, it spreads in different direction. Children, as it is daytime, it is not clear. When it is dark, you can observe, children. Here, torch is an endpoint. The light rays which are coming from the torch are the examples for ray. So this is the way. This torch is also one of the example for ray. This is about ray. And before naming the ray, you should be very careful. Always you have to start with the endpoint. Children, I hope you understand all these basic concepts in geometry. So, you have to learn thoroughly and write without saying. Thank you.